I was 28 years old the first time I was incarcerated, not convicted, and I was fighting a murder charge. Technically, I was falsely accused. I didn't have anything to do with it, but they said it was three of us. Then they narrowed it down to two. It was me and my brother. I stayed in jail fighting that charge 22 months, and that somewhat, you know, I'm not going to lay the blame on that. But it did. It somewhat laid the path for my criminal activity. You know, I come out, I was home maybe about 6 months. I started fooling with credit cards. You follow me? I started playing credit cards. And so, you know, I wound up getting busted. So from there, I squared up. You know, I wound up with a probation and I was cool. Then I still had a substance abuse problem, but I worked and did what I had to do. The drugs kind of like took over and it was costing me where I couldn't work and use drugs at the same time. So I started selling drugs again. That prior incarceration back in 1981, more or less was the path for me getting involved in criminal activity. And that's how I had a 25 year sentence. I was fortunate enough at 25 years flat, but I was fortunate enough. Thank God for the law library, me knowing how to read and write, and knew a little interpretation, I had an illegal sentence, but the judge sentenced me to the 20 years, and that enabled me to get out. So I had did 13. First 72 plus, first of all, it was founded by six formerly incarcerated people. That number 72 stands for the first 72 hours a person is released. That's one of the most critical times of their lives. That's what's going to determine whether or not him or her is going to make it out here in society. But they had a whole lot of barriers and obstacles. But that plus, that stands for all the wraparound services a person would need. Housing, clothing, employment, ID cards, Medicaid, Social Security card, birth certificates. When they first come here, they still got on their state clothes, state bros. They don't even have clothing. And, you know, we dress them out. And then from there, we, you know, see what they need. Later this morning, they needed Medicaid, food stamps. You know, she didn't have those benefits. And we helped her get it. We do all that. But we also have a legal program. You know, we got a legal team. Like, if you got warrants on you, most people have, again, another barrier we knocked down with the DMV. Now they give you what they call a provisional license. If you owe money for tickets or whatever, you can get your license, a provisional license, for 1 year, and that's based upon you paying them every month to pay the fees and whatever you owe. We also have a small business incubator. Some guys have entrepreneurship liking that they would like to get off into their own business. Well, we have a class every Tuesday night. This is working. The word is out. Man, get with Ben and them. They gonna get you straight. Go by the 472. I get letters every day. You know, guys want me to represent them on the pardon board or the parole board because it works. I just had a hearing yesterday. This guy was dead on arrival. He wasn't getting out. They was gonna deny him. I spoke for him and showed him the different parts of his incarceration and how he had changed to a degree, and he was, when he get out, he was going to be part of our umbrella because he has a resident plan. He has a place to stay. He was going to be part of our organization, and I think that was the key, because the guy who I thought was going to vote against him, that's the first thing he said. My vote today is to grant that you get with the first 72 up on your release. You follow him, man? And so the other two follow suit. So my goal would be to expand, have thousands or hundreds of people working throughout the city, to another state, to another parish in this state. You see where I'm at? You know, if we don't have to, we just want to, in other words, you say you live in Minnesota. We just come there and give you the footprint and help you get started, and you put it to work. You run it yourself. You just be a part of our network. Long as the people in charge are formerly incarcerated, it can't help but work.